Hello everyone. So here we'll go for discussing about the preparation or determination of working operating cycle estimation. Means, as already we discussed about the operating cycle, the time period required for complete the cycle will call it the duration of operating cycle. So here I am going to explain how to calculate the duration of operating cycle. So the following information is available of Swagat Limited. So they are giving this information. Average stock of raw materials and stores 200, work in progress inventory 300, average finished goods inventory 180, average accounts receivables 300, average accounts payable 180, average raw materials and stores purchased on credit and consumed per day 10, average work in progress value of raw material committed per day 12.5, average cost of goods sold per day 18, average sales per day. So this is what the information given. So now here they are giving the all the information of raw materials, stores, work in progress, finished goods, accounts receivable, accounts payable, and also the information related to the sales. With these information they are asking you to calculate duration of raw materials, duration of work in progress, duration of finished goods, duration of accounts receivables, duration of accounts payable, and as well as duration of operating cycle. If you want to get duration of operating cycle, first you should calculate all these things. So addition of all these durations minus the accounts payable, you will get the duration of the operating cycle. So let us see how to calculate one by one. The first thing is duration of raw material stage. So the formula which we will use for calculation of duration of raw material is average raw materials and stores. In this problem, raw materials and stores are given combinedly. So we are taking both together. If the stores has not been given, just we'll write it as average raw materials. So average raw materials and stores divided by average raw materials and stores purchased per day. So in the problem, average stock of raw material and stores has given 200. And average raw materials purchased on credit and consumed per day is 10. So now average raw materials and stores is 200 divided by average raw materials purchased per day is 10. So the time period, the duration of raw materials will be 20 days. So in the same way, in the second question they are asking, calculate the duration of work in progress. So in the same way, we'll go for calculating the duration of work in progress also. Here also the formula is average work in progress inventory by average work in progress inventory entry committed per day. Committed per day. So in the problem, average work in progress inventory given as 300, average work in progress value of raw material committed per day is 12.5. So 300 divided by 12.5. So the answer will be 24 days. This is the duration of work in progress. So next they are asking you to calculate duration of finished goods. Duration of finished goods. So for all the calculations, the formula will be remaining same, but the terms will be changing. So here also, average finished goods inventory by average cost of goods sold. So means finished goods means the product is ready. So we will consider the cost of goods sold per day. Average finished goods inventory by average cost of goods sold per day. So here average finished goods inventory is 180. So average cost of goods sold per day 18. So 180 by 18. So you'll get the duration of finished goods as 10 days. Next, fourth one, they're asking duration of accounts receivable. Accounts receivables. So here also the formula is average accounts receivables, that is the accounts receivables given in the problem, by average credit sales per day. Average credit sales per day. So here in the problem, average accounts receivables is 300, but they have not given credit sales. So whatever the sales they have given, that will be considered as the credit sales. So average accounts receivables per day is 300 and average credit sales is 20. So you'll get 15 days as the duration of accounts receivables. Next, they're asking duration of accounts payable. So here also the same formula. Average of accounts payable. Average accounts payable by average credit purchases. Average credit purchases. So here average accounts payable is 180 rupees and purchases is 10. So 180 divided by 10. So you'll get the duration as 18 days. So now we calculated all the things. Finally, they are asking you to calculate duration of operating cycle. So for this, the formula will be first duration of raw materials plus duration of work in progress plus duration of finished goods inventory and duration of accounts receivables minus duration of accounts payable. Means whatever all the information we have calculated, raw materials duration plus work in progress duration plus finished goods duration plus accounts receivables duration minus accounts payable. That will give you the average duration of operating cycle. So duration of raw materials is 20 days plus duration of work in progress is 24 days plus duration of finished goods 10 days and duration of accounts receivable 15 days minus duration of accounts payable 18 days. So the answer will be 51 days. So this is what the duration of operating cycle. So this is how we'll go for calculating the duration of operating cycle.